Welcome back. I just arrived into New York a few days ago, and it's been pretty hectic since I got here. Just been busy every single day and pretty rainy as well, so I haven't actually done any filming at all. But I'm staying up in the Upper West Side at the moment in Manhattan, and yeah, it's pretty nice up there. Not nearly as cold as Banff, so it actually almost feels like summer here. Well, not really. It's still like 1 Celsius, but I'm just at Central Park today, and just planning to explore Central Park the whole day and just chill out. I just love it here, even though all the leaves are gone on the trees. It's still just really beautiful, just hanging around and watching the world go by. But yeah, plans. I'm here for another week and a half in New York City. I always love coming back to a city that I've been before and exploring it in, you know, a new headspace or at a different part of my life. Cause cities just feel different, depending on your mood at the time. It's also really cool to be here by myself because I always wanted to do some independent travel, and it's given me a lot of time just to relax and think about life a bit more, and just think more about things. Got word a few days ago that there's an anti-Trump protest going on at Central Park today, and there's going to be speakers such as Michael Moore, Robert De Niro, Julianne Moore, and Alec Baldwin. And as I'm a big fan of Michael Moore's work, his documentaries, thought I better go and check this out. So yeah, just heading down to Central Park. Let's hope it's interesting.
We should bring him to America.
Tonight's rally on the eve of the presidential inauguration. The one, the only, the living legend, Mr. Bob De Niro.
De Niro's career is a disaster. Passed over for Godfather 4 and Magnificent 7. Pathetic. Another tweet. De Niro should give back his Oscars. Voting was rigged. There's only one true Raging Bull, and that is Vladimir Putin. You can love your city, as I do, and not love everything about it either. That may have been what I was thinking about when I said I wish you know who would leave this city. I don't care where he goes. I just never thought he'd go to Washington. He's a bad example of this country, this city. This city. This city.
Michael Moore. Also, I couldn't have read this speech because I'm dyslexic.
Let's hear it for Cher. And the people of Flint, Michigan, thank Cher. And the people who've shown up there to help them with the fight against the governor for poisoning their water. So thank you, Cher, for that. This final night of what anthropologists will call the pre-Trumpian age. It will be a short-lived age. But it will be significant. And they will be studied for centuries. This is the beginning of our 100 days of resistance. Yeah! 100 days of resistance. Yeah! And that's just the first 100 days, but I like to think positively that it's only going to take us 100 days. We have to do something about it. This, I'm sorry to have to put this out there. Doesn't seem to affect him. I said, right, yes, that's right. He's not affected by the bad news when he talks about his sexually assaulting women. He's not affected by the bad news that comes out of him calling Mexicans rapists and murderers. That's right, he's not affected by that. What's he affected by?
Money!
He's affected by comedy! He has the thinnest skin. The thinnest skin of any bully I've ever met. If you make fun of him, if you ridicule him, or if you just show that he's not popular, I remember the night after the election. On the 9th of November, a bunch of us just randomly got in the street and marched to Trump Tower. Anybody there that night? There weren't a lot of us, but it was a few hundred people. And he's up there in his tower, in his penthouse, tweeting, "Demonstrators outside my home. Unfair. Unfair. This is how he'll implode. It's his Achilles heel. And we don't need to just depend on the comedians to do this for us. Everybody here has a sense of humor. Use it. Use it. Is there anyone better at doing what I've just asked us all to do? I just want to say, I've been standing out here in the freezing cold for a long time. I have to go to the bathroom, I have to pee. But I'm holding it in, I'm holding it in, I'm not going to pee. I'm going to a function at the Russian consulate tonight, I'm going to hold it until I get there. And then when I get to the Russian consulate, I'm going to have a really, really long pee.
Of different religions, different races,
different sexual orientations, different genders that stand together saying that we may have seen you win an election, but we have not lost our minds. As you sit there tonight at the inaugural concert in Lincoln Memorial, you need to talk to President Lincoln, Mr. Trump. President Lincoln will tell you that slavery and oppression based on different races and different people is wrong. You need to talk to Lincoln while you're there tonight.
This man to dismantle everything that we work for. So who's got the power?
We got the power.
Who's got the power?
We got the power.
Somewhere else. We are a nation of immigrants.
Man, I need you. I need it tonight. Did you need this? Man, I needed to be with my brothers and sisters here that to know that there's hope in the world and that we have one another, right? Martin Luther King, brother Martin Luther King, I love you. I know you're here with us tonight. Thank you for your wisdom and your leadership and showing us the peaceful way to move through the oppression that we're facing today.
This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island. From the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land.
Stop me as I go walking my freedom highway.
Mark Ruffalo. Sing the one about the wall, Mark.
Big high wall there.
So the rally's just finished, and that was actually really funny because Cher came out at the end. Is it Cher? Cher? I forget. And they tried to get her to sing, and she's like, no, I'm 70, I'm not singing. And Robert De Niro was there, Mark Ruffalo, you know, that was really cool seeing them all. But it's been about 1 Celsius for 3.5 hours, so I'm really cold now. So, okay, heading home to warm up. So I'm here at the Natural History Museum. A friend of mine from Australia just got here a few days ago and she suggested we go check it out. I've been here before, I spent 5 hours, but this museum is so big, I think it needs a few days to get through it. So, and it's really, really cold and rainy outside, so really no point being out. So, should be good. And tonight I'm going to an ice hockey match, it's my first time ever. That's over in Brooklyn, so that should be really fun as well. And apart from that, yeah, we've got 2 more days after today in New York, and then I'm catching a train down to Philadelphia, working my way further south from there.
Wow, 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 wow. Wow, wow. Wow, wow. Wow, 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 wow. Wow, wow. Wow, wow. Wow, 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 wow. Wow, wow. Wow, wow. Yeah. Will you stay just a little while, babe? Just a little while. Just a little while. Just a little while. Will you stay just a little while, babe? So just a little while, just a little while, just a little while.
Yeah, hold on, wait a motherfucking second. I know you stressed. I've come down to Chelsea, which is at the bottom of Manhattan, and just going to go and have some breakfast at the Chelsea Market, which is this awesome place to get seafood and such, good coffee. And I've got a big walk plan today. I'm going to walk over to Brooklyn and then all the way up the riverfront to Queens and then back across the Upper West Side, so it should take me about 6 hours. I'll start by walking over Brooklyn Bridge though, of course, because I love that bridge so much. It's just, it's great.
Okay now baby, don't you be my side, don't even try. I'ma go crazy, girl, you save me, meditate me, give me peace of mind. It's only she and I, ocean floor, how deep we dive. We be high, looking for another fucking tree to climb. She was playing hard to get, I read between the lines. Binge watch Sopranos, made it all the way to season 5. I am her, she is I. She had to come, she a freaky side, leaving me behind.
Will you stay just a little while, babe? Just a little while, just a little while, just a little while. Will you stay just a little while, babe? Just a little while, just a little while, just a little while. Just a little while, just a little while, babe.
And when you walk into the room, all I think about is what I wanna do to you. I don't wanna be polite no more. Make yourself at home, where the fuck you gon' go?
Yeah, go,
girl. And when you walk into the room,
and I hadn't actually been here before, but it's so beautiful, hey. It's been sitting here for hours. You have the Brooklyn Bridge just up here. And here you go, the Manhattan Bridge. This is so perfect. Damn!
New York! New York!
No doubt!
No doubt!
New York!
No doubt!
New York City! New York, New York!
New York, New York,
New York,
New York,
New York,
New York City, New York, New York,
New York.
Hey yo, once upon a rhyme where the scenery sets, you see stress. Streets a matter of life and death, no regrets. Life's a test, trite with special effects. Neighborhoods full of reps, cities of projects, where the young cadets get stripes from the vets and comrades. The quest to be the next, to finesse, collect debt and select best with death threats. Object, cheddar, better your total net. With trends and seven ways to express their outfits. Friends get wet, trying to make ends connect. Avenues to check, boulevards to sweat. The smell of gun smoke's more common than cigarettes. We got clicks for wreck, we like pits for pets. We got Giants and Jets and Knicks, Yanks and Mets. We like.
I had a bit of a stuff up this morning. I was supposed to get up at 8:30, get a bus and get the train down to Philadelphia at 10, but I slept in till 11:30 until housekeeping woke me up, so I missed that bus. But I booked another bus. I'm heading to Philadelphia now. Hope you've enjoyed this video. I've had such a good time in New York, and yeah, I'm looking forward to coming back already. But next stop's Philadelphia, Baltimore, then DC. So, see you there.